Tanya. Today we are going to perform special test for SI joint pathology. First test is approximation or compression test. Patient position, side lying. Put your both hands over the upper part of the tibia crest. It will cause the forward pressure on the sacrum. An increase in feeling on SI joint is indicative of SI joint pathology. Test, gaping test. Patient position, supine lying. Palpate both the ASIS and apply crossed arm pressure on the both ASIS with downward and outward pressure. This test can be performed without crossing the arms as well. The pain produced by this test over unilateral, gluteal and posterior leg pain indicates a probable sacroiliac joint ligament pathology. Third test, Gens lens test. Patient position, side lying. While performing the test, the left leg should be the uppermost leg. If the test leg is the right leg, then lie down on the left side. Ask the patient to hold the other leg towards the chest, flexing it. Now stabilize the pelvis and hyperextend the uppermost leg to be tested. Pain over the sacroiliac joint indicates a positive test. Fourth test, Patrick or Faber test. Patient position, supine lying. Now cross the leg to be tested and put it on the other knee that the foot of the tested leg is on the opposite knee. Now push down the other knee towards the examining table. If the knee stays straight to the opposite knee or falls down on the examining table, it indicates a negative test. If the knee stays above the other straight leg, it indicates a positive test, which is indicative of a sacroiliac joint pathology. Fifth test, Biermann's test. Patient position, prone lying. Flex the knee to 90 degrees of the test leg and extend the leg. Pain localized in this sacroiliac joint indicates a positive test, which is indicative of anterior sacroiliac ligament pathology.